Hey guys, this is René for GNS 3 Vault, and in this video I'd like to show you how the conditional debug works. Okay, so you are probably familiar with debugging on a Cisco router, and maybe you have also seen debug and then use an access list. So let me just show you what I mean. So let's say I want to debug something. Then we have a whole lot of options. But you can also say, for example, debug IP packet, and then you can refer to a access list, because this will narrow down your debug. So this is pretty useful, but what you can also do is a debug and then a conditional debug. And I'll just show you how this works and why you want to use this. So for example, let me do debug IP rip, and I'll just want to see all the different rip things that are going on. So debug IP rip, and let's wait a little bit till we see some stuff. The rip is kind of slow, so we'll have to wait a little. And there we go. Okay, so what do we see? Let me disable the debug. You can see that we are getting rip packets that are sent to the fast Ethernet interface, but you can also see that we are sending rip updates to the loopback interface. Now let's say I only want to receive debug information for rip from the fast Ethernet link. So I want to ignore all the loopback stuff. Now, what you can do is use the conditional debug, and this is how it works. Debug, and then condition, and you can see there are a whole lot of conditions, but I'm gonna use the interface option. So interface, fast Ethernet 0, and now it says condition 1 set, and let's see what happens if I now use the debug IP rip. And we'll have to wait for a while. Here we go. So we are still seeing the rip output from our debug. But as you can see, I'm only seeing the fast Ethernet stuff. So I don't see the loopback information anymore. Yep, that's all there was. Okay, so that's what the conditional debug can do. So, for example, just specify the interface where you want to see the debug stuff from. Use that for the debug condition, and that's it. So that's how you can do it. And make sure that if you disable your debug, that you get rid of the debug condition. Just say no debug condition. And you'll get a big warning, because if you have a lot of stuff going on, you might be flooded with debug information if you disable this condition. So proceed with removal. I'm gonna do no, because I want to keep it, but type yes and you can get rid of it. And I think that's the end of this lab. So we did a debug and it only showed rip information for the fast Ethernet interface. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and till next time.